This gorgeous looking Raspberry Pi case is the best $90 investment for your Raspberry Pi 5 setup. I think anyone who wants to use Raspberry Pi 5 on their desktop should get it because it offers more than just its stunning looks. Let me dwell on its features as well as share my experience and opinion on them. Your Raspberry Pi 5 needs a cooling system and the official inexpensive active cooler does a decent job at that. But if you want to use Raspberry Pi as a desktop or for some intensive tasks, it starts getting hotter before choking up completely. SunFounder has been making accessories for Raspberry Pi ecosystem for a long time, and their Pironman 5 Max handles it with a mix of passive and active cooling. Know that this is an upgraded version of their previous Pironman case. The Max has a darker look and 2 SSDs, among other things. More on the differences in a separate video. Pironman 5 Max has this tower cooler to passively cool your device. And then there are these 2 RGB fans to add active cooling. Surprisingly, they were set to run by default, but you can easily configure them to start when the temperature reaches a certain threshold. I put them at 45 degrees of CPU temperature as it hardly reaches beyond that for casual computing thanks to the effective passive cooling. You can control the RGB lighting on the fan to have them always on, always off, or turn on only when the fans are running. There is a tiny lag between the lights of the 2 fans. So unless you have an intense OCD, you won't be bothered with this. Cooling is just one aspect of this magnificent Raspberry Pi case. It converts your bare-bone Pi 5 into a mini PC by adding extra ports. The Pi 5 still uses mini HDMI ports, but the Pironman 5 case converts them into full HDMI ports. Now you can use your regular HDMI cables. That's a relief. All the 4 USB ports are neatly accessible in the back. The micro SD card slot is conveniently located at the front along with a dedicated power button. You can press the power button once to turn it on. While running, press it once to bring up the shutdown menu or double press it to quickly turn it off immediately. You're not losing the versatility of your Pi as all 40 GPIO pins are easily accessible from the side and they are neatly labeled too. It also has an IR receiver at the front for your experiments. Although I don't have a Pi cam, I kept the FPC cable accessible in this manner. This Pironman 5 Max features a dual NVMe PIP board, which is an upgrade on its previous edition, which had only 1 NVMe slot. So here you can put in 2 SSDs and have a RAID setup, or you can have 1 SSD and 1 AI accelerator. Keep in mind that this is a PCI Gen 2 switch, and thus you're not getting PCI Gen 3 speed like the previous Pironman version. However, that should not be an issue as it's good enough for random IO operations. I have used 2 SSDs here, and I'm going to experiment with the RAID setup. I'll share how it went later. Pironman Max features do not end here, as there is this tiny OLED display that gives a quick overview of your system resources. You can see the IP address, disk storage, CPU temperature, RAM consumption, and this is also configurable from the handy dashboard which you saw earlier. The OLED screen needs tap to wake or shake to wake. It displays for a few seconds and goes to sleep again. Saves a tiny amount of power, although I would prefer to keep it on all the time. I find it convenient that it displays the IP address of the Pi, helps a great deal when I want to SSH into it. The RGB lighting adds to the charm of the case. There are 4 LEDs located at the top that throw the lights down. By default, it is blue mood lighting. You can configure their color and lighting pattern to match up with your desk and room setup. You can also control its intensity, which is a good thing as the semi-transparent dark glass may not always show the lights in its full glory. A tiny but useful feature is the inclusion of RTC battery, and thus giving the real-time clock to your Raspberry Pi. Your Pi doesn't need to be connected to the internet to give you the correct time when you power it on after a few hours or a few days or a few weeks. Before you get too excited, there are a few things you should know. Like many other SunFounder products, this too has DIY touch. The case needs to be assembled, which is not complicated, but still take a look at the official assembly video to get a gist of what kind of effort it will take for you. I used the paper manual as there were no assembly video when I received it, and it took me nearly an hour to get it up and running. Assembly needs to be done carefully as well. If you put wrong end of FPC cable or if the attachments are not fit properly, you will have to struggle with opening the case again to fix it. In my case, I had the fan wire in front of the fan and the fan started making awful noise. I quickly fixed it by tucking in the wire, but these things may happen, just so that you know. Pironman does not support all kinds of SSDs. Go through their list of supported SSDs first. Pironman also has a list of compatible operating systems, the Python script and dashboard that lets you control the RGB lights and other behavior works only with these operating systems, and you have to install the Python scripts explicitly. Ever since I have started using these Pironman cases, my Raspberry Pi not only stays cool, it also looks super cool. Now, a price tag of $95 could seem like a lot, but Pironman Max is not just a case. It transforms your Pi into a mini PC with a miniature gaming rig kind of looks. You get full HDMI ports, power buttons, OLED display, and two SSD slots. It enhances the capabilities of your Pi. Another good thing is that they also take care of taxes and import duty. You can order it from their official website. The new version is not available on Amazon yet. If your budget allows it, this is surely worth investing in your Raspberry Pi setup, especially if you use it as a desktop. And that's my opinion. What about you? The comment section is all yours.